served as a president of OIKOS International in St. Gallen, Switzerland. And I was very lucky to actually experience what Andy was mentioning, to work with people who actually are active citizens or who are trying to become ones. And I was accompanying them on their path, helping them discover their passions, connect to the topics that relate to them personally, as Neda mentioned, and also help them to get the confidence, as Andy mentioned, and knowledge to act. Petra said that there are teachers who influence your life. I met one bit later. It was at the university where I was doing my first degree in environmental humanities. And she introduced me to alternatives to mainstream economics. And it was a crucial moment for me because then I realized, oh my God, the economics as it is being taught and discussed is actually not really addressing the issues that matter to me and that matter to many students. And I have become quite radical. And on this journey of being radical and critical, I realized, yeah, but perhaps I need to understand too, right, what the mainstream is in order to be able to change it. So I moved from strong radicalism that somewhat stayed in me also towards dialogue. And I started studying at the very mainstream university, University of Economics here in Prague. And that's also where my OIKOS path started. And that's also where I learned that students are agents of change too. And I'd like to introduce you to the great field of students' actions and share with you how students reflect their curricula, and they do it, and in a very good and critical way. And then guide you through various activities that students are doing to address the gap they see in the curricula. And then perhaps show you some examples of how students entered the curricula and shaped them. And I believe that they are strong allies for all of you here. So let me introduce, first of all, how students reflect on curricula. I found a research or the survey of Net Impact, that's the organization that gathers students who are reflecting on sustainability in education at a business school. 3,000 students share their perspectives on nearly 100 programs, mainly business-oriented, and MBA programs in the US and also in Europe, France, Italy, or Spain. And what they were missing and what they were asking for, they see that the social environmental issues are important to business long-term success. And they feel that the crucial topics are climate change, energy supply, product development, supply chain, which relates also to fair trade, that some of you might be interested in and already working concept, human rights, and fair labor. What they are missing in the programs and they would like to have are more hands-on activities that are aimed at sustainability-related issues or projects that they can be working on. Integration of social and environmental themes in the curriculum. And they also feel that the social and environmental issues should be priority for business schools. The dissatisfaction with the curricula over time grows. So it gives us a signal that the education and the reflectivity of education is becoming bigger and bigger. And you can see that in 2014, many more students were slightly moderately or not at all satisfied with their education. When we moved to Europe, I picked a really interesting student group in France called PEPS Economy. They did a research at 50 universities in France They even published it later in the Journal of Pluralism and Economics Education. And they analyzed the curricula, so what they are being offered at their universities. I found the results pretty sad. As you can see, they are missing the real-world economic issues. The economic schools are quite often discussing the economic theories, but not really addressing what matters to all of us. And then you can see that the economics that fail when dealing with the financial crisis or other topics. They miss the time for reflection. They like to reflect on history of economic thoughts, on various economic theories, on pluralism within economic thinking. So the total average of reflexivity in a current curricula in France is also low. And there's a huge isolation from the other social sciences. I really like the name. They are optimistic. They say from terrible to terrific under the economics curriculum, and they are really trying to work on it and make a difference. And so let's then move towards the more positive aspects, because I believe there is a hope and huge potential to change it. I experienced it in OIKOS, where I could see over 200 projects per year done by students in their chapters all over the world. In India, in chapters in Pune, Kolkata, New Delhi, in Kenya, in Germany, in Georgia, or in Azerbaijan. So there are all the student clubs based on the universities. They are trying to reflect on their curricula, shape it, and bring the topics that they are missing. So that's why I'm saying addressing the gap. Because what they are not being taught, they are actually bringing there. So they are inviting lecturers to speak about alternative economic theories, to address the global issues such as supply chain or the global trade and its and the inequality that actually is reflected. So one of the examples, currently there is happening an OIKOS Academy on Sustainable Business in Prague in the Czech Republic at the University of Economics, a set of lectures read by students and inspired by the OIKOS Copenhagen. In Azerbaijan, the students are trying to bring the global issues and discuss the sustainability at the university. So sustainable future training is organized by the students for students. The topic of GMOs discussed by OIKOS Valor chapter members who invited students to see what actually GMOs are bringing. I really like the Summer School of Social Entrepreneurship in Mestia, in Georgia. Really beautiful region, which is currently under big pressure of a very heavy touristic development. And the students are trying to discuss how actually the region can develop in a sustainable way and keep up the beauty of the nature, but also being economically sustainable. Stream towards degrowth, organized by OIKOS Leipzig. What I liked the most were the moments that all these students from all over the world met, and they could share their perspectives. And it was quite, I would say, eye-opening for me, because then you see how many different angles views of sustainability are there all over the world, and then the understanding and inspiration among each other is really crucial. Addressing the gap, I'd like to mention two campaigns that are, for me, one of the most important I have experienced so far. That was the open letter of students all over the world who are trying to change the economics curricula. And they say, this lack of intellectual diversity doesn't only restrain education and research. It limits our ability to contend with the multidimensional challenges of the 21st century, from financial stability to food security and climate change. This was the movement that actually hit the media all over the world, and they are continuing. They are continuing with doing the surveys, the one I showed you from France, and there is a lot of information lacking. universities and other regions in Europe. So they are trying to fill the gap. Also, they organize a Global Action Day, motivating the students at the universities to actually address their professors and start a dialogue about changing with education. One initiative that developed from the OIKOS learning circles was the COMET, Change Management Education Initiatives. That's maybe an offer for you, because the next step of the students who want to discuss about methods and ways how to shape the education. So they plan to organize workshops in 2016 to come to the universities and facilitate the dialogues among teachers, key community stakeholders and students to reflect on what the education could look like. And then in the end, shaping the curriculum. There are already some success examples when students entered the curricula. I wish I could have shared more with you. Maybe it's also up to you to try to co-create courses with students. I really like the OIKOS Tübingen example when students organized a discussion on microfinance, its pros and cons, challenges. And this actually happened later to be a course started being taught at the university. The same happened in Konstanz. Where students actually designed together with teachers for some sustainable urban development. And what I liked the most was the initiative of the dean of Wittenherdecke University, who created his microeconomics course together with students. So I believe that there really is the potential to work together with students. And my question relates to that. So how can we work together, students, teachers, local communities, to improve and shape our learning environment? Thank you very much.